Welcome back to Riton University, guys. We're doing scope picking 101. What we've done to help with this process is name our scopes and categorize them by use. So people would continually come and say, hey, I need a new scope, Jerimiah, what am I gonna get? And you know, my two questions are, well, how much money do you have, right? And what are you gonna do with this scope? And so that's how we've done it. We have an X1, an X3, an X5, X7. X7 is all the bells and whistles, and it's going to be the highest price scope. X1 is going to be the lowest amount of features and the most budget-friendly scope. Now that you can kind of get an idea how much money you want to spend, what are you going to do with it, right? So we have primal line, that's for hunting. We have a tactics line for tactical shooting. And we have a conquer line, which covers just about everything else, but primarily long range, precision, and target shooting. Okay, so now we've decided what we want to do with our scope. So let's say we're hunting. What makes a primal scope a hunting scope? A few key features here are capped turrets, right? Because as you're walking through the woods and getting up and down and maybe coming out of a deer stand, you just can't have your turrets be bumped and moved. So the primal line is going to be completely capped turrets, which is going to keep you safe from that happening. And quite honestly, they're going to be just a very simple, easy to use scope that you can use in the field for hunting. The tactics line, you know, what's tactical? What makes it tactical? Well, let's talk about that a little bit. So with a tactical scope, we need a little more close. It's a closer range shooting. It's more moving around. So you can also expect to have cap turrets on most all the tactics line of scopes. Again, because you might be coming in and out of houses, if you're a police officer, up and down, in and out of a car, out of the back of a trunk. Again, you need things to just be set and work well. Something you're gonna find with most all of your tactics line of scopes too, is they're gonna be a lower power variable. And what that means is, if I'm coming into a room for an engagement, I don't need any magnification, I don't need power. I need an aiming point. Illumination is something you're gonna find in the tactics line, because that's nice in those kind of low light situations. But I don't need 24 power, right? I need something where I can come in close and I can dial the power up. So we have 1-6s, 1-8s. Those are the kind of things you can expect from a tactics line. The conquer line, my personal favorite line, is gonna be kind of all the bells and whistles and all the gadgets and all the stuff that's cool right now. What does that mean? Well, we are gonna have tactical turrets on these ones, right? Because we're changing yardage, we're changing target distances, things of that. So you're gonna be able to dial and see those nice, crisp. You know, you can feel the turrets with a glove on. You can hear the turrets. These are the things you can expect from that conquer scope. We're a lot of first focal plane in the conquer line. What makes that fantastic? I don't know. Maybe you'll have to go to the what's first focal plane versus second focal plane version of Riton Optics University. These are some of the features that you're gonna find with the different scopes. We'll go more in depth to these features, but this is a way for you to decide what scope is right for me and what can I expect from that scope when I get it.